Hi, this video is for all the new mothers out there who have trouble with their lactation. Being a new mother myself, everything that I'm going to talk to you about in this video are things that I have done and they have worked 100% for me. So I hope they help you as well. I want to start off by saying the choice to nurse your baby is completely personal and is your decision. So the most important thing is for us to make sure that we don't allow another person to judge us or our choice. Being a new mother, it's only natural that you feel stressed and exhausted with your new responsibilities. While it's the most beautiful feeling to nurture and bond with our little one, the lack of sleep, the whole process of understanding your newborn, and the drastic changes that your body has gone through will leave you feeling tired, exhausted, and stressed most of the time as to whether you're actually doing your best. Stress and anxiety are the number one causes for reduction in breast milk production. It is important for you to have a method of coping with stress. This is personal and will vary from person to person. Give your body some time to adjust to the drastic changes that it has gone through. Give yourself a few days to help regulate the process of breast milk production. With all the hormonal changes and the physical changes, it might take a day or two for the breast milk supply to kick in. Most mothers want to do all the work themselves. This is a great time for you to seek and accept help from your partner, family, and friends. Let them do all the boring work, your household chores, cleaning, cooking, doing your laundry, running your errands, while you can take care of yourself and the little one. Spending time pampering and bonding with your little one is a great stress buster. Having ample time to rest and recover is essential. So when I had my little one, I had people who came to visit tell me that I should sleep when the baby sleeps. But this was really difficult for me, and honestly, I just couldn't get myself to do that. If there are people who can sleep when your baby sleeps, great, go ahead and do that, because that is exactly what you need, sleep. But for people like me who can't do such a thing, what you can do is you can take time out, lie down on your back and rest as much as you can. Don't do anything that is strenuous, don't exert, don't do your household work, but just rest and relax and allow yourself to recover from your delivery. After your baby is born, your breasts operate on supply and demand. The more the demand, the better the supply. So if you keep breastfeeding, the body will produce more milk. It is recommended that you nurse your baby frequently and at regular intervals, and when you do nurse your baby, offer both sides. Now, if your baby doesn't feed, you can pump milk at regular intervals. When you pump milk, your body feels there's a demand and hence the supply gets better. Finding a comfortable position to nurse is beneficial to both you as well as the baby. So you can try different nursing positions like cradle hold, crossover hold, sideline position, football hold. There are various other nursing positions that you can try and see what suits you the best. Or you can even use a breastfeeding pillow to help position your baby. This will also help you with the latching, which brings me to my next point, latching. It is important to ensure that your baby latches properly. If your baby doesn't latch properly, you can try gently tickling the baby's mouth with your nipple or bring the baby closer to you. Ensure that the baby's mouth covers the nipple and the areola. If the baby still has trouble with latching, I'd recommend that you consult a specialist for help. Adequate hydration is very important for your body to be able to produce more milk. So keep yourself hydrated and drink a lot of water throughout the day. One little thing you can do is make sure that you drink one glass of water every time you feed your child. So before you nurse your baby, drink one glass of water, and this way you remember to keep yourself hydrated. You can also drink human water or any other juices, fruit juices, but make sure you don't add sugar to it and you have it with the pulp. There's a video that I've uploaded of lactation tea, which is extremely beneficial to help increase the supply of breast milk as well. It's a very simple tea, just 3 ingredients, so you can look that up as well. Eating the right kind of food is very important. So I tried a lot of things with my diet, and here are a few things that really helped me. Green leafy vegetables like spinach, kale, fenugreek leaves or methi leaves, carrots, drumsticks, beets, tofu, garlic,
Use garlic in moderation if you have a problem with the pungent smell. Cereal grains like oatmeal, barley, nuts like almonds, cashews, pistachios, walnuts, etc. Seeds like cumin, fennel seeds, sesame seeds, fenugreek seeds, holy basil or tulsi, bajra or pearl millet. This can be used either as a savory or can be made into a porridge with milk and sweetened with a little bit of jaggery.
There's an Ayurvedic herb called Shatavari, which is very effective as well. So if you can get Shatavari, you can use Shatavari. You can either mix it with milk or you can make a tea out of it, or you can even make a decoction or a kashaya and then you can have it. I hope these things help you increase your breast milk production and help you with your lactation. If you have any other questions or if you have any other problems, you can let me know and I'll be more than happy to help you out. Until I see you guys in another video, stay fit and stay tuned.